Welcome to the third day of joberg2c.
If you heard it all before, don't tell me anymore. I'll tell you what I see.
So what did you do on Sunday morning? Well, we're in Reitz. It's cool, it's misty, it's a little bit overcast, but conditions perfect for the longest stage of the joberg2c. 120 kilometers we head to Sterkfontein Dam. The trail is superb. Lots of nice big open roads and incredible views of the Drakensberg as they come into view. Jabulani single track along the river, and of course Mount Paul is the day's final challenge before we end on the banks of that magnificent dam, Sterkfontein. We've had a great night here at Reitz. They've looked after us royally. We look forward to a great day's riding.
Race faces were firmly in place among the men and women at the front of the start chute. The biggest case planter in the universe led the field out of Reitz. It didn't take long for the hierarchy to be established. The team of Hill and Bester and the solo big hitters Bjerkus and Kruer up front. The alpha women's team of Teresa Ralph and Sarah Hill of Galilea Risk had a big group of men trying to hang on to their flying wheels. The first water point came at 35 kilometers. Bjerkus greeted the crew, but there was no stopping the Piga Eurosteel man. He had Dark Horse Wheels TIB and Sean Nick Bester of Dorma Carver in tow. The evidence of the rain, the river was swollen as they headed into Jabulani's single track. The second group was led by Gerry Bjerkus of the leading vets team. He and Johan Labuschagne would go on to claim their second stage win. Mixed leaders Mike Posthumus and Amy McDougall of Dorma Carver were tacked onto the back of the group. Mount Paul loomed ominously ahead. Bjerkus was the first over the top, Kruer in his wake as they flew into the descent. Sean Nick Bester and Andrew Hill were around 3 minutes behind them. Amy McDougall climbs Mount Paul like a spider up a wall. She and Mike Posthumus were just shy of 20 minutes ahead of Corinne Auvernay and Vincent Fluke in the mixed. Ralph and Hill were similarly dominant in the women's race, and they went on to win the stage by 42 minutes. At the finish at Sterkfontein Dam, HB Kruer managed to outdip Matthijs Bjerkus of Piga Eurosteel in 4 hours and 26 minutes. Dark Horse Wheels TIB clocked 4 hours and 29 minutes, 13 minutes ahead of the second place Team Sage, Craig Uri and Luke Evans. And in the Amaboka Boki Global Mixed Race, Mike Posthumus and Amy McDougall of Dorma Carver increased their overall lead to 68 minutes with another stage win. For many of the field, Stage 3 was to be their longest on a mountain bike to date. The numbers do make it a daunting challenge, 121 kilometres. The cool, misty conditions prevailed deep into the morning, making for ideal riding weather. Dams are full and the streams are flowing strong. Almost as strong as every rider in this field.
If I could find a new state of mind. Locked up inside, I'm still flying blind. If I could find
we try to, how do you call it in English, take it easy by the day. Let's see it by the day. So not spend all our energy in the first few days, but we have to keep something for day 6 and 7, and then we put the pace a little bit higher, I think. Everything is very good organized.
Lost in the tide, just let it subside. What she left behind, I still couldn't find. Life and times.
I was born for this. All day, every day, morning, noon, and night. And then I get my wife afterwards.
Heading to Mount Paul.
That's my mountain, Mount Paul. You see my name? Paul. This my mountain, my mountain, I'm coming. Yeah, yeah, he's mad. I don't know what he had for breakfast. The rest of us missed out on it.
New state of mind. Locked up inside, I'm still flying blind. If I could find a safe place to hide.
children from Harrison School welcomed us home to Sterkfontein like soldiers returning from the front. And it must be said, some may have confronted a mortal enemy and emerged triumphant. Well done to all on a monumental day. The evening fare, oxtail from the good people at Karen Beef, was entrusted to the culinary gifted parents from Harrison School, and boy, did they do a great job. We were well set for day 4 as we say goodbye to the Free State and drop into KwaZulu-Natal.